Mana?
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Good morning. Good morning, everyone. Thank you. Thank you sa inyong bagay. You know what? Kanang happy kay mi ba? I know. Also, sa kapusan na happy good mo karon na amo diri. Okay, even though the rain, no? Nagkarin yun ta. Nagtawag ni effort yun ta na wari diri. Di ba? So, ako lang yun ang mga tao, no? Ang church na to mapapaka na to itong mga patuloy. Okay, mapaka na to. Salamat ta. Kailangan na diri. And I would like to request everyone to stand up. Okay, atong kanta nito. Church.
Thank you.
I want to encourage everyone, no, na karon di ba sa tanan sa tibuok semana naggabay. Nabiga, gabi kayong gaitan sa Ginoo sa tuha, sa tanan nato mga ibang buwan. Sometimes na ibuwalta, but we know na nagoy Ginoo na pwede nato i-share ang atong ibati. So, nag-pray ko karon ba, Lord, baka nang i-open nato itong hearts. And kaning next song na atong kantahon with our hearts.
Thank you. And so far, we have been learning about Peter's restoration. We have been learning about kanang Moses, kanang availability. And recently, last week, we have learned how our challenges, how our difficult situations can be opportunity for growth and maturity. Matod pa nga sa takeaway last Sunday, endure to mature. Okay, endure to mature. Today, we are going to talk about faith in action. Okay, faith in action. And we are going to look on a very unfamiliar passage. Okay, I've asked a couple of people kung nakapamilyar ba sila ninyo story, and so far na yung story lang na katubag. So, very unfamiliar passage found in Hezekiah chapter 4 verses 1 to 7. So, if never Bible, if never Bible, turn with me to Hezekiah. Hezekiah chapter 4. Pala siya ka na growpoint old joke. Growpoint old joke. Without 2 Kings. Kaya lagi na siya sa Bible. Ang Hezekiah, wala na siya sa Bible, guys. 2 Kings chapter 4 verses 1 to 7. Okay, 2 Kings chapter 4 verses 1 to 7. And we are going to take a look on the story of a widow's olive oil. Okay, wala siya nasa, if naman isin yung Bible, kanina ay title sa chapter, wala siya title sa aling chapter. So let's read it all together. Magbasa ko from the ESV. Second Kings chapter 4 verses 1 to 7. Now, the wife of one of the sons of the prophets cried to Elisha, "Your servant, my husband, is dead. And you know that your servant feared the Lord. But the creditor has come to take my two children to be his slaves." And Elisha said to her, "What shall I do for you? Tell me, what have you in the house?" And she said, "Your servant has nothing in the house except a jar of oil." Then he said, "Go outside, borrow vessels from all your neighbors, empty vessels and not too few." Okay, empty. Then ay kanang daghana. Okay, daghana. Then go in and shut the door behind yourself and your sons and pour into all these vessels. When one is full, set it aside. Pagpuno na usa, paraplay. So she went from him and shut the door behind herself and her sons. And as she poured, they brought the vessels to her. When the vessels were full, she said to her son, "Bring me another vessel." And he said to her, "There is not another." Then the oil stopped flowing. She came and told the man of God, and he said, "Go, sell the oil and pay your debts, and you and your sons can live on the rest." Bakit nindot kayo siya mga story? Few weeks ago, one of the kanang well-known nga celebrity, okay, ni publicly confess siya of his security in the Lord. Okay, ningalan siya nga, alam mo ba ito, boy? Kanang confident kayo siya ba? Confident kayo siya, wala siya nahadlok, hindi ko ako sa exact na Tagalog nyo, kay paispas kaya siya kustorya. So ako na nag-ibig niya sa aling yung Kuya Kim. Ano siya? Confident kayo siya na after bito siya pamatay, he knows that he will be in heaven. Kaya kita ko na video, interview niya, and kaya na video, daghan kayo ang ni-criticize. Nagkaridakan kayo ang ni-criticize. Daghan ang ni-appreciate, but daghan ang ni-criticize. Nagani? And was out when I watched that video, niyala ko sa kong pagaling yun, more of this. More of this. We need Christians on kana maging open and kana bitang bold to declare their faith. Why? Because we cannot deny the reality that the world is influencer. Okay? We cannot deny the reality that the world is very influencing even to the church instead of the church influencing the world. Dili na siya nato ma-deny. And if ato ang talawon, the passion of the church, okay, I'm talking the passion of the church for the Lord and for the Lord's word are not as fervent, are not as kind of passionate, are not as hot, are not as kind of zeal or zealous, no? Are not as kind of zealous as in the past. Compared in the past. Dili na sa nato ma-deny. Why? Because even I myself, kada kasi natin ko na ba? May makaingon ko nga, ang akong passion now compared in the past, kaya hindi siya same, you know? And, nai mga couple of reasons, but, probably, ang main factor that we are not experiencing this passion, that we don't have this kind of passion, is that we stop taking steps of faith. In a daily basis, we stop asking God to open the door for the lost souls. Open the door for opportunity. If ni Amgali open door, we close it. Why? Because we don't want to take a step of faith. And that is yung mga reasons. It's probably because we, each one of us, have struggles and problems too. Diba? Tawa na ganda. Like, some of us are probably dealing with physical or mental health. Some of us are probably dealing with marital issues. Struggling with work-life balance. Some of us are probably struggles with dealing with other people. These things should not be belittled, but these things should not be a hindrance as well. This should not be a hindrance to take steps of faith. What do you do when you are facing some giants or when you are in a difficult situation? We may not have all the answers to that, but we can have some help from our passage. Okay, we can have some help from our passage. Our passage is a true-to-life story, by the way. It is a true-to-life story of a widow who suffered in pain and poverty. Yet when her faith meets the faithfulness of God, she experiences God personally. When your faith meets the faithfulness of God, miracle happens. When your faith meets the faithfulness of God, you will meet God personally. You will encounter and experience God personally. So let's take a look sa tuwang passage. Good job, God. Now, verse 1. Now, the wife of one of the sons of the prophets cried to Elisha, "Your servant, my husband, is dead, and you know that your servant feared the Lord, but the creditor has come to take my two children to be his slaves." Now, it is important to if dili mo familiar sa history sa Israel, Israel before are like Korea. Ni ay north of south. NI North Old South. Before, during this time, right na po niya ang story, ang Israel were divided. Ni ay Northern Kingdom, ni ay Southern Kingdom. Nagtago na siya after sa pag-reign ni King Solomon. Okay, ni ay division kinita mo after pag-reign ni King Solomon. Ang 10 ka tribes sa Israel, pabila mo na may 12 tribes in Israel, ang puno na tribes sa Israel, muna sila gitawag na Northern Kingdom. Ang 2 tribes, muna sila gitawag na Southern Kingdom. If magbasa ka ng kanang Southern Kingdom, mas ka na siya ka ng kinisilang duha, mas common siya. Kung maghisgot ka din mong Israel sa kings, maghisgot na siya sa 10 tribes. Kung maghisgot mong Judah, kung maka-encounter mong tribe of Judah, Southern tribe na siya. Okay? So, during this time, muna siya 9 division nito po, and in this ka ng situation, niay mga groups, in order for these people to kalamitaw preserve the knowledge of God, they formed various groups. Niay Bible school. Okay, during this time. And kini sila ng mga tao, they were men who are faithful to preserve and to pursue the knowledge of God. Okay, can remember, during this time, people have left their God. Okay, they worship idols. Lahi na dilin na bitaw si Jehovah God. Kung sa kanta pa, in Israel's time, Jehovah God was God alone. But soon they worship hidden idols made of stone. Kaya ba? So, these men, with their desire to pursue the knowledge and to preserve the knowledge of God, they form various groups. And kana siya ng group, kung saan tuwa na siya, Groupwit Institute, napapuntay Groupwit Institute, Pivot? Or sa una, kay SMCM, ito kayo gano'n? Niya kayo mga Bible school na yung mga classes, sila, ang tawag ka nila ng mga tao kay Sons of Prophets. Okay? Sons of Prophets or Company of Prophets. Although, dili ni sila mga official prophets of Israel at this time, mga kwanan ni sila ba? Persons, gani ay gift of preaching. Okay? Believers, gani ay gift of preaching, nag-gather together, nag-study together to know God personally, to know God more, and have the opportunity to share God to others. And ang prophet at this time kay si Elijah o si Elisha. Mga main nga prophet. So, si Elisha o si Elijah kanang had a close relationship with these groups, with these various kanabitaw study groups. So it's natural na ang babae, ang wife, ni-approach ni Elisha. Okay? It's natural. And in our passage, ato sa makita naman, kanag-reveal ba, ang common nga notion nga if faithful ka, if kanabitaw pa, faithful ka ng alagad sa Ginoo, i-bless ka materially. Dinay sa itong passage, opposite ang nahitabo. Kini opposite ang nahitabo. Namatay ang husband, na nalupong sa utang ang family. Na ganing opposite ang nahitabo. So it doesn't mean nga i-faithful ka ng alagad sa Ginoo, dato na takayo. Okay? Dili na wala na siya na pasabot ana. So, it is natural to think that way, but that's not reality. Paano siya? Expectation versus reality. Kung taas kayo yung expectation, pagsugapod ka ng reality, disappoint you ka. Because that's not reality. Okay? Clear na siya sa itong makita ng principles sa itong passage. So, verse 1. Now the wife of one of the sons of the prophets cried to Elisha. The woman comes to Elisha with despair. Okay? The woman comes to Elisha with despair. Ang kining word na cry means to shriek out of grief. This word identifies the sound of a broken heart. Muri siya ka ng klase sa hila na ka ng imong madunggan kung di ka kapasar niya. Now, muri siya klase sa hila na imong madunggan kung guon bitaw ka kayo or kalangay loss of loved ones. Ako personally, most of you, kay kasulay yung inaling hila, but then, life lang yun siya ang hila yun. Kana bitaw hilak yun nga hilak out of despair. So niyala siya when your servant feared the Lord. And so when she approached Elisha, she was saying this to make it as her ground bitaw to approach him. To approach Elisha and ask for help. This is also an indication na ang pagkapubri nila is not out of kwan bitaw ka ng laziness or kanang pagwalda sa kwarta ba. It is out of his piety. It is out of his kanang devotion diha sa Ginoo. It is out of this kanang strong, firm belief to pursue God and not to comply with the world's way of worship. Okay? To take a step, to be firm sa iyahang faith and therefore lost all worldly advantages. Again, it reminds us nga, ang faithfulness diha sa Ginoo does not guarantee material prosperity nor kanang health without physical healthiness. Okay? Some of us, when we are faithful to God, sometimes faithfulness to God will cost us our dream job. Sometimes our faithfulness to God will cost us our dream salary. It will cost us our dream house, our dream spouse, or even our dream life. Because faithfulness to God does not guarantee material prosperity. Okay, faithfulness to God does not guarantee material prosperity. But in any case, nahadlok ito maging faithful sa Ginoo, ningana si Jesus sa Mark chapter 8 verse 36. For what does it profit a man to gain the whole world yet loses your own soul? Means, faithfulness to God is a risk worth taking for. Faithfulness diha sa Ginoo. And here, the wife did not only lose her husband, but also on the verge of losing her two sons as well. So, makita ko sa ito ang passage, niyala siya nga, but the creditor has come to take my two children to be his slaves. The sons were supposed to be working as hired servants, but ang ilahang creditor kay lahi ang ganahan. They were supposed to be working as hired servants until the year of Jubilee according to the law of Moses. But again, the creditor wants them to be his slaves. And during sa ilahang time, the creditor has all the right sa iyahang gihulaman. Sa iyahang gihulam. In fact, sa Proverbs, the borrower a slave to a lender. Okay? Karon naman ang the lender is slave to the borrower. Karon naman na. Diba? It's only in the Philippines nga ikaw may giyotakan, ikaw may maulaw. Diba? Ikaw may hulaman, ikaw may hulikay. Diba? Ibang paninglon, kung masya kayo ka na, isang pagkayaan mo ang gihulaman. Only in the Philippines, but that should not be that way. Because the Bible says a borrower is slave to the lender. So, muna siya, Losing her husband is already bad enough, but losing her sons is making it worse. She is over her head in debt and she doesn't know how she can make it. So this family is in a serious and very difficult situation. It is so serious that if it's not being handled well, it can lead to death. Financial situation. Debt. Difficulties sa iwasan tinabuhi. Magkanang mabaon ka sa utang ba? Dili na bitaw makaya sa dilit mahandol sa pressure nito. Asa ka mangita ng kabayan. It's so serious that it can lead to death. In fact, makita na siya nato sa mga siningan, sa movies. Recently, kay Nai girelease ang Netflix nga kanang Hunger ba? Na-watch mo Hunger, kanang cooking na siya nga, about cooking na siya nga sa liga. And niya'y part dito nga, kanang ang chef kay nagluto siya para ading ang family. Wala ka balo ang chef na katuyang dilo, katong ang family kay last supper na dito siya. Kay, suicide family dito. Reason kay baon niya sila sa utang. So serious kay ni siya and it can lead to death and I wonder how many of us are in that situation today. Dili ka probably baon sa utang but you are in a serious and difficult nga situation. At some point we will all arrive at the lowest point of our lives. Some of us have passed that point already. Some of us are currently on that point, or some of us will arrive on that point. But we don't know exactly what you are going through, when you are going to go through those kind of points. But God brought you here, and He wants you to know that there is help and there is hope. There is help and there is hope. Your situation is not the end of the line. God is. Your situation is not the end of the line. God is. Your way out begins with your faith in God. Your way out begins with your faith in God. In their season of difficulties, the widow stacks out in faith. In spite of her pain, problems, and lack of possibilities, she looked up to God for the help she needed. Even though she couldn't see a way out, she knew that she couldn't see everything. Even though she didn't understand everything she was facing, she still believed that God cared and that God could do something about her situation. And so she cried out to the Lord in faith. She cried out to the Lord in faith and God responded through Elisha. God responded through Elisha. No matter what you are called on to face in this life, turn to God in faith. No matter what you are called on to face in this life, turn to God in faith. For the help and for God will help you. Why? Because He cares. And He is able. He cares and He is able. So verse 2, Elisha said to her, "What shall I do for you? Tell me, what have you in the house?" And she said, "Your servant has nothing in the house except for a jar of oil." Now Elisha's response reflects God's heart for us. Okay, Elisha's response reflects God's heart for us. God is willing and ready to help us. See, God is willing and ready to help us. It would have been easier for Elisha to tell the woman, "Okay ra na. Lindot na ka na, muli na lang sa inyo ha, and then wait for the Lord's provision." Diba? It would have been easier that way. But Elijah took the different path. Makita niyo ni Anas Elijah, What? Ay, si Elisha siya. What shall I do for you? And makita niyo nga, kanang Elisha chose to let this widow experience God mightily by involving her in the process. Okay, Elisha chose to let this widow experience God mightily by involving her in the process. And sometimes this process involves erasing our faith and expanding our faith. Erasing our faith and expanding our faith. So, Elisha asks, what shall I do for you? Now, if niya'y person niya mudoon sa inyo ha, mga yung tabang, unsa may first inyong pautana? Diba? Naturally, we would say, unsa may pagkatabang? Diba? And so, kini siya mag-response ni Elisha, it is natural for Elisha to ask, what shall I do for you? And when she asked that question, it puts the person in a position to see the need and the reality of not being able to meet the need on their own. Kumuta na ka, unsa may akong ikatabang nimo? Kana nga person yung gipakutala would realize the size of her need and the inability to meet the need. He asked this question so that her faith from herself can be erased. So that she will know that she will not trust on herself. Now, that she will not have the resources to provide for her needs, to meet that debt, mabayaran ng utang. His question was designed to erase her faith in herself. Often, God will use our trials and pains to bring us to the place where we can see our needs and our inability to meet them. Okay, God uses that sometimes. God does this often to erase our faith in ourselves. As long as we think we can, He won't. What's the point of asking help from the Lord if you think you can? But so as long as we think we can, He won't. And this truth is clearly seen throughout the Old Testament. When Israel are feeling confident over themselves and fail to look on God for help, they always end up in the losing side. This is true in the past, and this is also true in the present. This is also true to them, and it's also true to us. When you think you can, He won't. Okay? When you think you can, He won't. Not only did Elijah ask, what shall I do for you? But also, at the follow-up, then siya, tell me, what have you in the house? So, after God erased her faith in herself and her abilities, He began the process of expanding her faith. Elijah asked this question to point out to the widow that she may not have much, but in reality, she already had everything she needed to obtain what she wanted. She couldn't see it, but God has already provided her the very thing He would use to meet her needs. Wala na makita sa widow. And this is true to us believers as well. First, in 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 3, the Bible says, His divine power has granted us all things that pertains to life and godliness. You see, God has already provided whatever we need in our season para ta maka go through. God has already provided what we need. Sometimes what we need is just strength to carry on or to push through to whatever season we are in today. And God has already provided it. God has already granted us all things that pertains to life and godliness. So, pagkata na siya ni Elisha ang widow. Basta may naasa inyuhang balay. Ana ang widow. Wala man. Gawa sa jar of oil. It was an honest response, I believe. An honest response. Kay di naman siya aware sa value sa oil. Wala man siya expect nga katong oil, jar of oil, may gamitan sa Ginoo. Like an egg, because God moves in a mysterious way sometimes. So, niya na siya, kining jar ani, ani nga passage is refers to a flask. Dili ni siya katong jar bitaw sa to usually common nga kanang dagko bitaw kayo. Normal no, kining siya na wala man except ani jar of oil. Unsa man ay kanang ani jar of oil? Nangyo ra. Mura na kung sa okan na bitaw sa ganang o kanang, if natakao mo o Santa Teresa, ma-appreciate ninyo ang ilang sudalag suka. Sudalag suka o patis. Kailangan siya kagidang manalo rin yun. Nasa kilid ni buta. Mura na inaana mo, flask of oil. If mag-research mo sana, kung mag-research mo pictures of flask, usahay kay perfume yung gumagamit sa kayo. Ngayon bro, ako alam ka ng gawin ka na ng justice mga kanan na mura na naman siya kaya naman siya na wala except ani. So yan dito ni wala. Okay? Wala siya ka-expect nga magamit na ito. So mura na siya gibutan niya sa kusina nga part pa as part sa kanang bro, kanang gibutan na lang yung pagsukat pati lagi. Wala na siya. So gamay kaayo siya. So, ang iyan matubag, normal na jugga ayaw nito, kay more maginay nasa iya. She sees it as something that has of no value and cannot be used to aid her situation. But the truth is, oil is a valuable commodity during their time. Oil is very valuable that King Solomon used it to pay for the cutters of wood as a wage during their time. So valuable kayo ang oil. Iyaha lagi set aside. Iyaha lagi set aside. What seems insignificant to her were the very thing God used to deliver her from her situation. It was the very answer to her prayers. Sometimes we look at our problems and they look so large. We look at our resources and they look so small. Yet we always fail to factor God in the situation. He places us in a place, in a situation where our faith in Him must be expanded. In this verse, we see God has a different plan. And it takes an eye of faith to see and follow the plan of God. Kinihan na siya na, we have nothing except ani. So God uses it. God has a different plan. And ato makita ang ganda siya ng plan ni mag-unfold sa following verses. Kinihan na siya verses 3 and 4. Then he said, go outside. Borrow vessels from all your neighbors, empty vessels and not too few. Then go in and shut the door behind yourself and your sons and pour into all these vessels. And when one is full, set it aside. Now, when you look at the surface level, it is a strange command. To a grieving, desperate nga tao. But it is a strange nga command. Why did Elisha give such command? On a surface level, it seems strange, but it actually opens a way for the widow to put her faith in the Lord into action. It opens her way for the widow to put her faith in the Lord into action. And also, it will make her get involved in the miracle that God will about to do. See, when God does a miracle to your life, He always involves you. Why? Because when our faith meets the faithfulness of God, miracle happens. When our faith meets the faithfulness of God, miracle happens. When she heard Elijah's response, verse 4, when she heard Elijah's response, she was probably wondering, how is she going to do it? Niyana ni si Elijah nga, pagbulakog mga empty vessels. So, unsaon na ko? Asa ko musugod? Unsa akong irason sa akong pagpangulaw? She was probably thinking that those kind of commissions. She was probably asking those questions. Was she afraid? Probably. Was she shy? Probably. Was she bold enough? Probably. Nevertheless, she steps out in faith and took Elijah's word as a command from the Lord. Elisha, nagigili si Elijah. Okay? Elisha's word from as a command from the Lord. She puts her faith in the Lord into action. She puts her faith in the Lord into action. That's probably what we need in the church today. We as believers should be willing to put our faith in the Lord into action. If it's not put into action, it's just words. If it's not put into action, it's just words. It doesn't make a difference. Okay? What is God telling you to achieve that you are not achieving? What is God telling you to do that you are not doing? You see, you took a step of faith in Jesus Christ as your Savior that you are saved. You took a step of faith when you take your board exam that you were able to pass. You took a step of faith to accept God has another plan for your life, that you had peace. It took a step of faith for me to be here. Took a step of faith. Unless we put our faith in the Lord into action, we will not experience miracle. When you kanisya ka mga miracles, dili di siya ka mga big time, you know? Daily miracles. Because God is a miracle doer God. He did not cease to be a miracle doer. He's always been a miracle doer. And He will always will be a miracle doer God. Unless we put our faith in the Lord into action, we will not experience miracle. Unless we take a step of faith, we will never bring the gospel to our community. Unless we take a step of faith, we will never see those chairs being filled up. Pabulo lang na sila ang event. About what in the church? Unless we put our faith in the Lord into action, we will never bring the gospel to our community. When the woman steps out in faith and collects jars and posts from her neighbors, it was God's opportunity to show Himself to them. They might think of her as crazy, but what a testimony it is when the Lord met her needs. God used her as a living testimony to others. He can do it to our lives as well. Again, we talk about how we love the Lord. And it's just words until He sends us to the valleys of life. When we are there and He comes to us in a big way, it speaks volume to the people around us. You never know who the Lord is speaking through your life. You never know kung kinsa, kung para sa unsaon ka paggamit sa Ginoo sa kinabuhi sa usa ka person. You never know the blessing, how blessed you are to that person. Let Him have His way. Stay steps of faith. So she went in, collect silang jars, sulod sila. Balay, pag-abot nila sa balay, there, climax. May imagine ba, if you are on their situation, sulod sila dito, okay, nagilang ako anak. Pag sulod nila dito, namin siya yung two sons. So imagine their conversation. Ma, dati nagkikita ang jar. So minato. Wala niya siya gisulti sa scripture, but we can use our imagination. Kung sa'yo nitabo during that time. Diba? Nagingo ng pastor na to bring it to our context. Nga, ito yung i-gather. Dahil nabito na itong flask of oil. Punong namin siya. With this. So, they started. Wala ka ba noong unsay, kada po ang first jar nito? Puno, may maha, nagdele. Wala ka ba noong unsay? Wala ka ba if they were fearful, they were afraid, they were kind of doubting, or perhaps they were excited. Wala ka ba? But let's use our imagination. Iputa na dito unang butang sa jar. Pagtulog. Imagine, iunana ka na kong mga susanag boy. If iunani ang jar, unang jar na gibutangan. Unang jar na gisundan pa. First nga pour sa oil. Nagkurog na ko yung mama. I mean, first nga pour. Lulog, puno. Duha. B. Uy, puno niya puno. Nakakatulong na, ikatulong na dyan. Imagine, nakahit ito silang pots, mga vessels, pilang rusa ito, kamakaniting ang mga sudanan na nilang isulod, sumurag na kung ilang balay ba? Kaupat, kalima, imagine their experience. Imagine how God has met them. Imagine the faith that grows because they have experienced God, they have seen God, they have tasted that indeed God is faithful, that indeed God is the Father to the fatherless, that indeed God will provide, that indeed God is the Jehovah Jireh, that indeed God will supply all our needs. Imagine the faith that rises up to the God of gods, to the King of kings, that we are serving a true and a living God. That the God that we serve, that the God of Israel, is the real God. The only God who can do miraculous things. And when God provides because they took a step of faith, God's provision was, di na kaka-explain. Grabe ang provision sa Ginoo. Imagine what happened during that on that private house. Imagine the rejoicing, the weeping, tears of joy, cries of joy, praises to the King of Kings, praises to the God of Heavens. Because when our faith meets the faithfulness of God, miracle happens. Miracle happens. See, God marvelously provided their needs. Can I explain? Only a flask of oil filled all the empty bottles, all the empty vessels. Because God is faithful. When He promised that He will provide their needs, when He promised that He will be a father to the fatherless, a husband to the widow, a provider, He will do so. Because God is faithful. God is faithful.
During this time. Kaya similar nga story. Personally, yung ano dito sa Ginoo nga, if dili ito ikaw, Lord, dili ito kami. One time, nai, sabi siya ako, itang party sa una. Ga-pray niyo, na nai mga estudyante, gusto mo join sa acquaintance party para ma siya nag-gaspel. Pero, ang mga Lord, kanang, alam ko na daghan kayo ni Daway. Ako personally, wala akong ga-expect na daghan. So we prepared a little. Kaya na ako nag-i-na, at that time, nai ka ng event sa school ko ba? So we prepared a little. God brought plenty. So pagtanaw mo, kung saan may kapakawan ni Mila. So we, couple of guys, we went with, kanda kita ang secluded area, we asked the Lord to turn the water into wine. The end, all is filled. All is filled. Okay? Grabe, when our faith meets the faithfulness of God, miracle happens. This is true in the life of this widow, and this is also true in our lives today. What hinders us from stepping out in faith and surrendering sa Ginoo? What hinders us from trusting in the Lord? When the widow stepped out in faith, she experienced, the family experienced God's limitless provision. Verse 6, Niana, when the vessels were full, she said to her son, bring me another vessel. And he said to her, there is not another. Then the oil stopped flowing. Only then, ninghunong ang oil. Nahurot ang oil. Only then. Kaya wala na sila ay kamutangan. If niya ko sa kaya kamutangan, nagpagpaghulo dito sila ang oil. Pagkatong oil, magpadayo na dito siya. Wala na sila kamutangan. Stop there. The oil continues to flow until the vessels run out. There was no limit to the amount of oil. The only limit was the number of vessels. God's provision knows no limits. The limit is our faith. If we can continue to trust in the Lord, then He can meet every need, move every mountain, and solve every problem. Because the widow obeyed the Lord without question, took a step of faith, putting her faith into action, God turns her mess into a message. From being a debtor to a distributor. There's no limit on what God can do in and through your life as long as you continue to put your faith into action. The woman was able to experience what is found in Ephesians. that God was able to do far more abundantly above all that we ask or think. When our faith in the Lord meets the faithfulness of God, miracle happens. Imagine your life. Imagine the closeness of your relationship with God. Imagine the impact you will have to the people around you when you step out in faith. When our faith meets the faithfulness of God, miracle happens. Pray that. Lord, we are thankful for your word, and we ask that you would take your word in our hearts, and at your perfect time, Lord, use it, God, to bring glory and honor and praises to you. Use it, God, to bring changes and commitment to you, God. Lord, use it, God, to bring an impact to this community, you know. Lord, more so, God, use it to draw us closer to you and you alone. We thank you, God, and we lift up these things. In Jesus' name, amen.